We want to graph the given linear equation using the slope-intercept form of a line, which is the form y equals mx plus b. If we have a linear equation in this form, then b will be the y-intercept and m will be the slope. But looking at our equation, we need to recognize that we're going to have to solve this equation for y in order to have this in slope-intercept form. So what we're going to do is first subtract the x term on both sides of the equation. So we'll start by subtracting 2/5 x on both sides of the equation. This would be 0, and then we'd have negative 1/3 y equals, we'd have negative 2/5 x, and then plus 1/6. Now to solve this for y, we're going to multiply both sides of the equation by the reciprocal of negative 1/3. Well, that would be negative 3/1, or just negative 3. So let's go ahead and multiply everything by negative 3/1, since everything is in fraction form. Notice here the 3 simplify out. Then we have negative 1 times negative 1, that's positive 1y, or just y, equals, here nothing simplifies, so we'd have positive 6/5 x. And then here, there's a common factor of 3. This simplifies to 1, this simplifies to 2. So we'd have plus negative 1/2. Let's go and just write minus 1/2. Now that we have the equation in slope-intercept form, we now know that the y-intercept is equal to negative 1/2, and the slope is equal to positive 6/5. Notice in slope-intercept form it's plus b, and since we had minus 1/2, we need to recognize that b is going to be equal to negative 1/2, which means the y-intercept would be the point 0, negative 1/2, and then m is equal to 6/5, which represents the change in y with respect to the change of x, often expressed as the rise over the run. So now to graph this line, we're first going to plot the y-intercept, which is negative 1/2. So it's going to be right about here. And then we'll use the slope to find another point on this line. Since the numerator is positive 6, which represents the change in y, we'll move up 6 units. And then since the denominator is positive 5, which represents the change of x, we'll move right 5 units from the y-intercept. So we'll go up 6 units, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then right 5 units, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the graph of the linear equation passes through these two points and looks something like this. So just to review, we had a y-intercept of negative 1/2, because in slope-intercept form we had minus 1/2 right here. And then since the slope was 6/5, we went up 6 units from the y-intercept, and then right 5 units. And that's it for this example.